Every day, we see how severe weather and rising sea levels are affecting people in developing and developed countries. It's time we had an honest conversation about our planet and take action to combat one of the world's most pressing challenges, climate change.
Data is probably the most underdeveloped resource we have on this planet, but data doesn't have to be overwhelming.
Over the past 5 years, the United Nations Global Pulse Initiative has partnered with companies across many industries to discover how insights from their privacy-protected data can be used to measure and improve human well-being. Effective action requires timely feedback. When it comes to climate action, what we can't do is wait until the impacts of our behaviors show up in irreversible changes to the climate system. Acting on what we now know will require a better understanding of ourselves, our awareness of risk, our patterns of consumption and production, and what motivates us to be willing to change how we lead our lives.
We just have more data that companies are collecting, whether it's transactional data about what we buy, whether it's social media information about what we observe, that's going to simply give us a much more granular picture of climate change across the globe.
By the end of 2016, we'll have hit an unbelievable 3.77 zettabytes of data globally. And as we layer this information together, we start to see patterns in the aggregate data traces we leave behind as we go about our daily lives. Data truly is our greatest asset in combating pressing global issues like climate change. At Western Digital, we know the potential impact that data can have on our collective future. Through initiatives like the Data for Climate Action Challenge, which we are collaborating with the UN Global Pulse on, we're encouraging the global research community to come together in search of those answers.
Global Pulse is an effort by the United Nations to understand how there are patterns in this data that can be used to stop outbreaks of disease, to respond to drought and hunger, and to improve public services.
So I think what we need to do more of today is to use technology in order to give more people an opportunity to give back, to have a chance to work on stuff that matters.
Researchers have found that they can use satellite imagery, the same imagery that forms the basis for these products, to monitor the desalinization of lakes, melting ice caps, and even illegal fires in the forest.
In 2015, world leaders adopted the new 2030 agenda, with 17 goals to succeed the Millennium Development Goals of the previous 15 years. Unlike the MDGs, this agenda is a universal one. It applies to everyone around the world, in both developed and developing economies, and everyone's participation and engagement will be needed to achieve it. It is also incredibly ambitious. We aren't talking merely about reducing poverty, hunger, and disease. We're talking about eliminating them entirely. The data revolution for sustainable development has to be a revolution not only in measurement, but in new management approaches, based on continuous real-time feedback. To achieve sustainable development, we must harness this real-time ocean of digital data. You are the key to our tomorrow.
The time is now.
Will you rise to the challenge?